At the outset, I thank the organizer for the opportunity to deliver a lecture at this audience. My talk is on the frames and its applications. Actually, the talk is motivated the decomposition problems in graph theory. There was very long standing open problem of the cycle decomposition of complete graphs that was very recently solved by Bryant and his group. And later, what about the same cycle decomposition or multi decomposition for the complete multi-parted graphs? So that was the problem corresponding to the complete graphs, but thing is still it is open in general, for very few cases it is solved. So to solve this problem, people have tried in many methodologies, but one such thing is the idea of frames. And there are other problems in complete graphs and complete graphs with a minus one factor when the order is even, they are called Ober-Ulbach problem and spouse avoiding Ober-Ulbach problem, and then the Hamilton-Waterloo problem. These are all related with the special type of cycle decompositions called isomorphic two factor shifts. To solve some of the unknown cases, the idea of frames was introduced by Stinchen, and he has in 1967 he has proved only the existence of three cycle frame in the complete multi-parted graphs, and that too with the idea of group divisible designs, where group divisible design is the generalized case of the VK lambda designs. And the, as you know, the VK lambda design is nothing but the partition of the complete graph into complete subgraphs. So with this let us see the basic ideas related to the basic definitions. First, before that, these are all the some of the notations used in our lecture. G of lambda, the lambda fold graph, that means the edge multiplicity lambda, and then the complete graph with the n vertices, the complete multi-parted graphs with mi parts of size ni, denoted like this. And the complement of complete graph, or we call it as independent set. And cycle with the n vertices as well as the path with the n vertices. So these are all the notations used. As you know, the combinatorial design theory deals with the partition of the given set into subsets of its some specified types. And they also have applications in many areas and in mathematics of many subjects of mathematics also. And especially the graph decomposition problems by using this. The group divisible design is defined as follows. So considering the set of finite set of points as x, and the G represents the partition of the set X into subsets called groups, and the set B is the collection of subsets of X with sizes from K, where K is a set of positive integers called blocks, such that every pair of points from distinct groups occurs in exactly lambda blocks, and no pair of points belonging to a group occurs in any block. That means it can be in graph theoretical notation also, you consider the complete multi-parted graph, whereas the parted sets are considered as the groups here, And then the decomposing that complete multipartite graphs into complete subgraphs, and the order of the complete subgraphs are from the set K, where K is the set of positive features. So that is the idea. And no two elements in the same group appears in any of the blocks, because of in the complete multipartite graph there won't be any edges. That's all. And we denote such the group divisible design by this this notation of type m, n1 power m1, n2 power m2, etc. That means what mi partite sets of size n1 like this. And the frame idea is from the group divisible design. See, in the group divisible design, the blocks are just the complete graphs. There is no condition on that. But whereas in the frames, the blocks should be partitioned into the partial resolution classes. Partial resolution classes means then the blocks can be partitioned into the spanning subgraphs except for one partite set, or we call it as like this. Each partial resolution class being a partition of the x minus cj, where cj is group of the group set G. So that is the difference between the frame and the group divisible design. And a near resolvable design, see that. Near resolvable design, the VK lambda BIBD, and we call it as the resolvable BIBD, with consisting of a V element set, and then K is the set of positive integers. We call it as the block sizes, and lambda is the multiplicity. So the near resolvable design is nothing but a particular case of the K lambda frame of type 1V, that instead of considering the multipartite graphs, you just consider the complete graph, that's all. So the frames as well as the group divisible designs are the general cases of the VK lambda and resolvable VK lambda design. There is an example here considering the set X with 8 elements, and G the groups 1, 2, 3, 6, 4, 8, 5, 7, and the B consisting of the set of blocks of size 3. See that the every pair of elements occurs in exactly one block here, and the block size is 3, and the no pair of elements of the group appears in any of the blocks. Therefore, it is nothing but a 3, 1 group divisible design of type 2 power 4, that means 4 partite sets of size 2. The size 2 represents the group size. That's all. The same thing can be the blocks of this design can be classified into the partial resolution classes like this. See that 3, 4, 5 and 6, 7, 8 is one partial resolution class, but the partite set 1, 2 is missing here, and in R2 the second partite set is missing, and in R3 third partite set is missing, R4 is the fourth partite set is missing. So this each RI is called as a partial resolution class because it contains all the elements of the set X except the one group in that. So we call it as the 3, 1 frame of type 2 power 4, that means the 4 partite sets of size 2. Considering the another example, see from the group divisible design, the same design can also be converted into the frame. And if the blocks of the group divisible design is partitioned into parallel classes, then we call it as a resolvable group divisible design. If the blocks of the group divisible design is partitioned into partial resolution classes, then we call it as a frame. That is the difference between the frame and the group, the resolvable group divisible design. See, considering the set X with this many points, and the groups are three groups here, and these the blocks of the set can be these things. And see that the blocks are partitioned into resolution classes. Each color represents a resolution class. It contains all the elements of the given set G, given set X. So the red color is the resolution class, and the blue color is resolution class of X, and the maroon and as well as the something like yellow, like the all the color, each color represents the resolution class. Therefore, as the blocks are partitioned into resolution classes, we call it as a resolvable group divisible design of type 4^3. Each group consisting of four elements, and there are three parted sets. That's all. Then, if the set K contains only the singleton element the K, then the K lambda group divisible design is denoted as small K lambda group divisible design, and when lambda equal to 1, we write it as instead of writing K lambda, you just write it as K group divisible design. Then pairwise balance, this is nothing but the general case of the VK lambda design, whereas there in the VK lambda design the block sizes are uniform. In the pairwise balanced design, the group sizes need not be uniform. It is also a group divisible design. It is also a group divisible design of type 1V. And there is an example, see here the X consisting of 6 elements, and the groups are considered as a singleton elements here, and then the blocks are size 3 and block size is 2. Therefore, it is nothing but a pairwise balanced design consisting of 6 elements, and the block sizes are 2 and 3 with the H multiplicity 2. Or we call it as the lambda is equal to 2 here. That means every pair of elements occurs in exactly 2 blocks. So, balanced incomplete block design, we call it as a BIBD, is a VK lambda BIBD. It is nothing but a K lambda group divisible design of type 1V. 1V means the each group consisting of a single element, that is all. In a group divisible design, if the groups consisting of more than one element, it is the general case of the BIB, that is all. In graph theoretical notation, the group divisible design is considered as the complete graph decomposition of the complete multiparted graph, whereas the VK lambda design is nothing but the complete graph subgraph decomposition of the complete graph. That's all. That is the difference between these two. So it is a VK lambda BIBD. If the blocks are partitioned into the resolution classes, then we call it as a resolvable BIBD, and the corresponding the group divisible design is a resolvable group divisible design. That's considering the 6 element set, and the block size is 3 with the lambda equal to 2. The groups are singletons. The block sizes are 3, Therefore, this is nothing but the 6,2, 6,3,2 BIBD. K3 decomposition of K6,2. See, each color represents the triangles here, and when we put together, you will get this one. And the transversal design is nothing but a particular case of particular type of group divisible design of type n power k. DD4,3 x consisting of the 12 elements, and the groups are size 3 here, and there are 4 groups here, and then the blocks are block sizes is 4 here. Therefore, this represents the block size and this represents the group sizes. Okay, the basic definitions of the group divisible design, and from the group divisible design, how we can convert that into a frame when the blocks of the group divisible design is partitioned into partial parallel classes. And if the groups of the blocks of the group divisible design is partitioned into parallel classes, then we call it as a resolvable group divisible design. These are all the basic ideas related with the frames. But the so far the group divisible design as well as the frames ideas is known for only k equal to 3 and k equal to 4 or something like that, but not for other values of k. So our problem is related with the cycle decomposition for the complete multi-partite graphs, because we are applying this idea of the frames to solve some of the unsettled cases of the Oberholbach problem. Therefore, we require some the graph theoretical terminologies here, the cycle decomposition of the complete graphs and the graph G, and the factorizations are also. As the in the previous lecture, Professor Palraja have covered all these basic ideas. I quickly skip these basic requirements. Each color represents a P3, therefore it is a P3 decomposition, and the idea of the reproduct and the for the graphs K3 and I3 is this one. Just corresponding to each edge of the first graph, we will have a complete bipartite graph for the reproduct. And the with this idea of reed product, we can have the notation for the complete multi-partite graph with the uniform part sizes like this. So the complete multi-partite graphs with the part sizes n is nothing but the reed product of a complete graph on m vertices, reed product with the independent set or the complement of K. So with the product graphs helps us heavily in finding the decomposition of the whole graph just by partitioning the into smaller graphs, and finding the required decomposition in the smaller part, and by compiling all you will get the required decomposition for the given graph. So R factor is nothing but the R regular spanning subgraph, and R factorization is nothing but partitioning the given graph into R factors. And when R equal to 2, this is a 2 factorization of G. 2 factorization of G is nothing but the 2 regular spanning subgraph such that each component is a cycle. The cycles need not be of same length also. If the cycles of the 2 factor is are of uniform length, then we call it as a CK factor, and CK factorization is nothing but partition of the given graph into CK factors. This one such example, considering this graph, and this is one C5 factor and this is another C5 factor. When we put together, you will get the whole graph. If the graph is not partitioned into the required the factors, then we are trying to find its near factors. So, for this the near factors of the graphs are introduced. Therefore, what is called near R factor? Factor is the spanning subgraph. The near factor is it contains all except but one vertex of the graph. That what we call it as a near factor. And the near H factor, if the factor is isomorphic to some graph H, then we call it as a near H factor. See that the given graph, and this is one the C4, near C4, this is not a C4 factor because this is not a spanning subgraph of the given graph, but the C4 is contains the four vertices of this graph and there is one isolated vertices. Therefore, this C4 contains all but except one vertex. Therefore, we call it as a near C4 factor. The graph can be partitioned into near C4. This is one near C4 and this is another near C4. Therefore, when we put all together, we will get this graph. Therefore, but the C4 factor of near C4 factor of K5 does not exist because of the edge divisibility condition. Therefore, we add the multiplicity. Okay, how these designs can be viewed in terms of graph theoretical notations? The K lambda GK G group divisible design is nothing but a decomposition of complete multipartite graphs into complete graphs. And this VK lambda BIBD decomposition is nothing but the decomposition of the complete graph with the lambda, edge multiplicity lambda into a complete graph with K vertices. And this the instead of considering the complete graph, if we consider the graphs or cycles, then we call it as a cycle group divisible design. And if the subgraphs are partitioned into resolution classes or the partial resolution classes, then if it is a partial resolution class, then the K lambda cycle decomposition is nothing but a K lambda cycle frame. If it is converted into the resolution classes, then we call it as a resolvable group divisible design. So, the literature on this is based on this, the motivation behind this talk is this one, the cycle decomposition of complete graphs and complete graphs minus one factor and the near C3 factorization. And the partial factor is nothing but the factor which contains except one partite set. And the H frame is nothing but the decomposition of the complete multipartite graph into partial H factors. So, this is the example of a frame considering this graph. This is nothing but the K4 with the I2. And this blue color represents a C3 frame because the each component is a cycle of length 3. And then this is a partial resolution class because this does not contain the elements of the one partite set. Therefore, this is what is called one C3 partial factor. And this is another C3 partial factor, and this is another C3 partial factor, and this is. See, in a group divisible design, this is nothing but blocks of size 3. The blocks of size 3 in the group divisible design is partitioned into partial resolution classes. This is one partial resolution class, this is another, and this is another, and this is another. When it is when the blocks are partitioned into the partial resolution classes, then it is nothing but a frame. And the partial, the block size is 3, therefore it is nothing but a cycle of length 3, therefore this is nothing but the existence of C3 frame in the graph K4 wreath I2. And there is another example for the same graph. This is a cycle of length 6 and this is also a partial resolution class, or in terms of graph theory it is a partial C6 factor, since it does not contain the elements of one partite set. So each color represents a partial factor, and the components of the factor is nothing but a cycle of length 6, therefore we call it as a C6 partial factor. When we put together you will get the whole graph, therefore it is nothing but the C6 frame of K4 wreath I2. Instead of considering the uniform cycle length, the people have also considered the different cycle length in the frame, because of the idea is to attack the unsettled cases of the Oberwalbach problem. The components of the two factor in the Oberwalbach problem are not uniform, therefore the people have also considered the different cycle lengths frame here. See that the components, one is C3 and another is C4, one left out partite set is missing. Here this partite set is missing in the C3 C4 frame, and this is missing here. Therefore, we call it as, this is nothing but a C3 C4 partial factor. And this one is C3 C4 partial factor, and this is another, and this is another. And if put together, we will get the whole graph. And since each partial factor is missing one partite set, then we call it as a C3 C4 frame of the K6 wreath I2. And Heinrich et al. Have shown that the CM factorization or near CM factorization of complete graphs with edge multiplicity 2 with these conditions. And Stinson, only who introduced the idea of frame, have settled this for the k equal to 3, and what we call it as the C3 frame of the complete multipartite graph when the necessary conditions also becomes sufficient. And then Ka et al. Have proved that the CK frame, or the existence of CK frame for the particular cases of K, when K belong to 4, 5, 6, with the possible exceptions. And the New et al. Have proved that the C3, C5, existence of C3, C5 frame of this complete multipartite graph is 8 multiplicity lambda. And here also the necessary conditions becomes sufficient. Chimayer has also proved that simultaneously the C4 frame of this exists, where the obvious necessary conditions becomes sufficient. And then Wong established some necessary and sufficient conditions for the existence of cube frames in the complete multipartite graphs, and none other than this, there is no general results were known for some time. Therefore, we have considered the problem for the general K, and initially we have considered when K is equal to 4P, where P is a prime, and we have established these results. And the general the result obtained in this case is when M is congruent to 1 mod 2 and N congruent to 0 mod 2k, there exists a C4k frame of a complete multipartite graph. And then for M congruent to and N congruent to 0 mod 4k, we have this result. By combining these, we have a general result, the C4p frame exists, and the obvious necessary conditions holds good. One is the vertex divisibility condition, the other one is the parameters condition. And later we have considered the same problem for instead of 4p, where p is a prime, we considered the even cycle frame. And these are all the some of the basic requirements for the C4 existence of C4-C6 frame of the complete multipartite graphs. So with the help of these results, we have established this result, the general idea, and this is for even cycle length, cycle of length 2k with the obvious necessary conditions. We have also established this. And the idea is this you just find the frame of the smaller graph kx wreath I2, and then each vertex is blown up to the set of size S now, and then corresponding to each the cycle you will get a graph like this. So this is the idea, each vertex is blown up into a set of size S, then the cycle C4 or C6 in the smaller graph will become a C6 cross IS, the wreath product, and the C4 wreath IS. And then the cycle factorization of these graphs can be obtained. And then as the C4, C6 frame exists here, one left out partite set is there for each partial resolution class. Therefore, by considering the cycles here as the wreath product of graphs, and you just have two elements of the set along with the partite set, the left out partite set here, then this becomes the wreath product of k s plus 1 wreath I2. This graph has a C2S frame. C2S frame means what? Each partial resolution class leaves one partite set. Therefore, the C2S factorization of this part along with the one partial resolution class will gives a C2S frame, C2S partial factor of the whole graph here. So by this way we can extend the existence of a cycle frame in the smaller graph to the larger graph. That is it. Instead of blowing up in the vertical way, we each vertex can be blown up into the horizontal set of a set vertices, and then the finding the existence of the frame in kx wreath I2 will also give the existence of the same cycle frame in kx wreath I2s. Yes, then the number of elements in the partite sets becomes larger. So this is the technique we have used from the smaller graph to the larger graph. So by this way we have obtained the previous results for any even cycle length, and then for the odd cycle length also we had a result like this with some exceptional cases. But the recently the Brotti et al have completed the problem by solving the exceptional cases also. Therefore the CK frame for the complete multipartite graph is now known. Okay, right. Then how these ideas are used in finding the solution to the some of the unsettled cases of the Oberwolbach problem? Just. And not only that, the existence of cycle frame also settles the cycle decomposition of the complete multipartite graph, and that too the uniform cycle decomposition is known, but for the different cycle lengths are not known so far. And the Professor Pal Raja and his group have settled the similar cases for the tensor product of graphs. So the results are published in the Equations Mathematics as well as the Journal of Combinatorial Designs in the year 2013 and 2014. The Oberwolbach problem, I think the problem is popularly known, raised by Ringel in the year 1967, the graph theoretical terminology of this problem is nothing but finding the true factorization of complete graph on odd number of vertices, or the complete graph on even number of vertices minus one factor. So that problem is known for several cases, but not completely settled. So this is one such example. See, Oberholbach problem, the cycle length is 7 of this K7, and this is the Oberholbach problem. Each the two factor consisting of cycles of length 3 3 3, the with K9. And when we put together, you will get that whole graph. Then this is the spouse avoiding Oberholbach problem. That means when the number of elements in the complete graph is even, you cannot have a cycle factorization or decomposition because of the odd degree. Therefore, we consider this as the spouse avoiding Oberholbach problem. And the graph theoretical terms, this is nothing but finding the two factorization of complete graph with by a removal of one factor in that. So this is an example for such case. And then I just simply show there are different variations of the Oberholbach problem, or the lambda fold Oberholbach problem and the Hamilton Waterloo problem. There are so many variations in that. I just give you the idea of these are all the problems, the cases known for the Oberholbach problem. And I just give the one slide how these the frame ideas are used to find the solution to some of the unsettled cases of the Orwell. So consider the complete graph with the 2x plus 1 vertices here, and then this can be viewed like this. And each part consisting of 2s vertices, and there are x parts, you include this infinity at the last part. And as we know that the frame ideas are known for these cases, you consider this as the left out partite set, and the partial resolution clause covers all these partite sets. You that singleton vertex along with this partite set will give you a complete graph on 2s plus 1 vertices. And you know the cycle factorization for this graph, isn't it? And for this graph, you know the partial resolution classes or the partial factor. So considering the partial factor of these partite sets along with the cycle factorization of this set will gives you the cycle factor of the whole graph. So by this way, corresponding to each partial resolution class, at every partial resolution class left out with the one partite set. Therefore, you can change this correspondingly to the every partite set depending upon the partial resolution class, and that the partial resolution class covering the partite sets with the left out partite set along with this form a complete graph, and the cycle factorization of this part along with the partial resolution class of this part will give you the cycle factorization. So this is the idea how these frame ideas are used to find the some of the unsettled cases, and this is example in that form. Just considering the left out partite set of the frame along with the set with form a triangle. So this triangle along with this partial resolution class gives a cycle factor. So that is the idea. Instead of the single vertex, if you have two vertices, then this becomes like this. The two vertices are considered, and this is the cycle generated by this left out partite set. Therefore, this partial resolution class along with this will form a factor of the given graph. The left out edges here, the horizontal edges of these cases represents the spouse avoiding problem. Therefore, the complete graph with the even number of vertices with the left out one factor, and the complete graph on odd number of vertices can be considered as the previous problem. So by this way, the frame ideas are used to settle the some of the non-existent cases, there have been unsettled cases of the overall bug problem. There are different the forms of frames are introduced to settle these cases, and I don't want to go through all these things, but there are cases semi-frame, and then modified group divisible design and modified frames. So these things are also used to find the resolvable group divisible designs. That means the factorizations of the complete multipartite graphs into complete graphs. But the general problem is not known, only for the particular cases when k equal to 3, 4 or something, not beyond that. So the youngsters, those who are picking up the research problems, can be taken up to solve some of the cases. So these are all the some of the selective references of
Any question? If there is no question, then have a big round of applause for the speaker.
Let us thank the speaker by presenting the momentum.
In this session, the second speaker is Dr. Shailesh Tipnis.